Noob Noob, what's your power, Throuple?
I'm going to go with Strawberry Shortcake, Demi Lovato, and the black kid from Charlie Brown.
That's a quadruple.
What's a quadruple?
It's four, Noob Noob. Oh. It's four. Why, hello, friends and fam. It's your man Z and Noob Noob here to discuss with you. I guess this is bad news. I don't know. Maybe you think it's good news. Let us know exactly what you think. But we're going to discuss the newest animated announcements from... Who are those guys again?
Oh, HBO Max.
HBO Max. Whatever they're going to call it in the future, nobody seems to know.
Discovery Max BO?
Yeah, Discovery
Max BO.
So let's look at the article. The one thing I wanted to mention before we even get started was that a lot of people are speculating that they're making these announcements because of the merger. So that way the public knows that these projects are available. So if they start axing the heads of HBO Max or some of the Time Warner heads who are creatively in charge of this, they can go, oh, wait, we didn't, you know, like the public wants this, which I don't know if we're going to or not, but... Let's look at the article. We're at the Nerdist here, and we're going to talk about the new Batman, Superman, and an additional super secret spinoff.
The throupling.
But let's talk about the one that seems like it might be okay. Let's talk about Batman.
Gargoyle
caped,
Man.
Caped Crusader.
Gargoyle Man.
Gargoyle Man. I don't know what's... that's.
That boy got some pointy ears.
Yeah, I don't know what era this is supposed to be from, but there is a little bit of good news, though. This is supposedly greenlit straight to series order for it, and it's a reimagining of Batman. Executive producers Bruce Timm from the original animated series.
Oh God, JJ Abrams.
JJ Abrams.
And we're done.
And Matt Reeves is on it, so maybe there's a chance that it's okay. But anything that bad robot touches is usually just trash now.
Yeah.
So I'm a little nervous about it. On a level of 1 to excited, I'm a little limp.
I don't know who... Well, it depends. Is Kevin Conroy coming back? Did they announce like the cast? No,
I don't think so. They did announce some cast for the next series we're going to talk about. Although, they're saying it's going to be thrilling, cinematic, and evocative of Batman's noir roots.
Ooh.
So, we'll see. I don't know. Again, they have no idea who's going to be the voice or some of the villains. So we'll see. Here's the one that's a little disturbing. This is a 2-season series order already.
Oh my God.
My Adventures with Superman.
That's hot.
So who's the my in this?
I guess it's Lois Lane.
I would assume it's Lois Lane. So,
or is it Jimmy? Jimmy is the third wheel throupling.
Well, let me read the description and you tell me what you think. My Adventures with Superman catches up with 20-somethings Clark Kent,
ooh,
the bright and driven Lois Lane, and their best friend Jimmy Olsen. Together they begin to discover who they are and everything they can accomplish. Wow. I think they're coming all the way out.
Oh my God.
It's a serialized coming of age story as Clark builds his secret identity. I'm pretty sure he already had it in Smallville. Embraces his role as the hero of Metropolis, not the hero of the world. Okay. And perhaps the world. And Lois, now growing into a star investigative journalist, takes aspiring photographer Jimmy Olsen under her wing. All the while, Clark and Lois are falling in love.
Under her wing how, though? Is she scissoring the man?
With Jimmy.
Oh, my Lord.
Taking down bad guys, stumbling over secrets. Oh, sounds so excited. Jack Quaid from The Boys is going to voice... that's going to be Clark Kent. And Alice Lee from Zoe's Extraordinary Playlist. Not sure.
Who's voicing Jimmy, though? He's the star.
That's clearly the star. I don't
Sam
know.
Sam Register.
No, he's a co-executive producer. Here's the kicker. Look right. I can't get
Josie
it to
Campbell?
High. Josie Campbell. Do you know who Josie Campbell is?
Is she a super woke bitch?
Read who she is.
Oh shit. Wasn't there something with She-Ra
and she got accused of being like racist for her depictions of one of the characters in the... This is I've heard this in other other channels like Heels vs. Babyface, and I heard it from, who else did I hear it from? Maybe from your boy Zach, I'm not sure. But they were all talking about, like, this is failing upwards in Hollywood, where you can have a not that well-received show like She-Ra, which you didn't watch, correct?
No.
I started watching and then checked out. I can't even get in the ways that She-Ra, like, bothers me. I mean, it was just very weird.
Because it's woke
weird.
And racist?
I'm going to make you watch an episode of it. You'll check, please.
No.
So it's a fresh take that delivers a modern, relatable Clark Kent along a fearless, whip-smart Lois Lane, both navigating small tasks of becoming adults and trying to save the world. So what I don't get is, A, Lois doesn't really save the world, except with her reporting.
She does with her journalism.
She does. But I like how Lois already had a established career before she met Clark.
No, Clark is establishing that career for her like the man he really is.
And that's not what's going to happen.
And Jimmy's
going to
take pictures.
Oh, the whole time he's going to be snapping pictures. Oh, this article doesn't talk about the additional news, which we can just...
Although, speaking of DC, they did announce there's the next animated movie for DC is Injustice.
That was part of the article I was going to talk about. Yeah, this isn't in this article. I could search it, but they're going... It's going to be animated Injustice?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Okay, so not live action. DC, so those animated, of you familiar with the video game, it's going to be an alternate timeline, apparently. What was the... the other announcement was... There's a whole bunch of stuff that they're doing in coordination with Cartoon Network, several movies and things like that. I don't know if we talked about it on the show, but the important announcement is for you Rick and Morty fans.
I'm getting a spinoff.
Noob Noob is getting a spinoff with the Vindicators. Although I'm not sure from the description, it said there's some time traveling dude hanging out with the
who cares?
They're all dead.
It's about me.
It's all about me. Noob Noob. So you're in. You're
I'm
all
mopping
in.
Mopping it up.
On a spinoff?
I got my mop ready.
You're that ready.
I am leaving the show to become famous as a janitor on the Vindicators.
Yeah. Get ready to get vindicated. Hopefully, I guess we'll do a review of that show whenever it comes out. We'll probably do a review of this show too, even though
you
I don't...
do you, bro. You do you.
Are you excited about any of these Noob Noob?
Oh, I want to watch all of them.
He's going to watch all
I
of them.
I hope it's not as cucky as this picture looks for Superman, but the Superman and Lois on CW is awesome, so hopefully this is somewhat decent.
We'll see. We shall see. Make sure to catch us as we live stream our audio podcast on Friday nights at 7:30 Eastern Standard Time, and keep an eye out for other videos that we're going to be doing as we release them for you to consume. If you liked what you heard here, make sure you punch Noob Noob in the face.
Or the penis.
Both of those are acceptable.
With your mouth.
Make sure you subscribe, like, hit those bells ding-a-lings. Yeah. I don't know about you, Noob Noob, but I think I'm going to trade it all in.
For
dog money?
Not pupper pennies?
Just dog money.
I like dogs.
Anyway, from us here at Our Reviews, we'll kill you. Not to kill you. We'll kill you. On to the next one.